Yes, now we will see the ordered singly linked list implementation in C++. Now, as usual, you declare include the iostream and then structure is defined and it's given the name node. Inside that, we have two fields. One is data field and another one is the reference field, that is address field, which is of type node again. So here, next we are declaring a class called linked list, where we make a variable of the type node. So here what we do is node and head. We have declared head is a pointer which is subtype node, which already we have defined a data type as a structured data type. Now in here we create a constructor called linked list, where we made initially there is no linked list. So that can be done by making head equal to null. Then we are declaring the member functions is empty, insertion, deletion, traverse list, search, update list and destroy list. Now we are going to see the implementation of them. Is empty. How you can check whether a list is empty? If the head pointer is equal to null, which means there is no nodes at all. So if head is equal to null, then it returns 1, else it returns 0. So integer is the one which is returned by this. It's nothing but either a 1 or 0. So if it returns a 1, which means the list is empty. Now the next one, we'll see search. Already we have seen the previous videos how it will search. So passing the data, it checks. And we have two pointers, previous and current. Previous is used to point to the previous node, and current, this pointer is used to the point to the current node. So now initially previous is made to null and then current is made to point to the head. Then in the while loop, we check whether the end of the list is reached or not. And then we check whether the data which we are passing is greater than the current data or not. Till that, if it is the greater than, then you keep on increasing in order to find the correct position where we want to search for a particular value. So here previous, in doing so, the current pointer will be moved to the next step till it reaches this condition. And the previous pointer is also made to point to the previous node by assigning like this. Then if the current is not equal to, then once it is, when it comes out of the while loop, we have found, if it is an insertion, we will be finding the location, correct location where we want to insert. So that will be between the previous and the current pointer. The location will be previous and current. If it is if the search is going to be given for a deletion, if it will be executed from the deletion function, then it will give the correct location where the data is present, which is nothing but current. So this pointer will hold the it will point to the node which has to be deleted. So these are the things which will be returned so that the previous locations can be modified in order to delete the particular node. So here, if the search value is present, then it will return 0, else return 1, or else it will return 0. So if while during insertion it has to return a 0, because a new element only we will insert. If the element is already existing, then if it returns 1, then we will say the data already exists. So that is what here we catch. So in insertion, this is the next member function, insertion, where we pass the value. So and we declare 3 pointers. This is for all these things we have seen in the previous video. And then we pass that value. And after once the search is over, it will have the previous pointer and current pointer. If found is equal to 1 during insertion, the data is already existing, so we are not going to insert. Else, we create a new node, place the value which are going to be inserted in the data field of the temporary node. Then we check this for the whether it is a first node or not. So that can be done if the previous is equal to null, then it is a first node. So in that case, you have to insert the newly created node as the first node. So what we do is we make that temporary node as a head, and head. Now that in the temporary next field, the previous head will be location will be returned. So but that can be done by this statement. Then else, It is in between. So what we do is, in the temporary next, we place the current location, and in the previous next, we make the temporary pointer, so that now the node has been correctly inserted. Now, deletion. While deletion, we insert, we send the value which in which the node is found, so that that node can be deleted. So that value we are passing it here. Here also we are using temporary pointers, current and previous. Then here again we use the search. So this definitely, if the element is existing, it will return a 1. So yeah, but if the element is not present, this search function will return a 0. So if found is 0, data is not found, so we cannot delete. Else what we are doing is, we check whether it is the first node to be deleted. That can be done by checking the previous pointer. If it is equal to null, then you remove the first node. That can be done by moving the head itself to point to the next. Else we manipulate the pointers, previous next, we are insert placing the value of current next, so that the current node can be deleted. Then finally we delete the current node. Then traverse list, what is this delete? This delete will remove the memory space occupied by the particular node. In this statement itself, the link will be gone, the node will no more will be accessed. That is why we are keeping it in a temporary pointer called curve. Then we release the memory space occupied by the node by using this delete statement. In traverse list, this will travel the whole of the list. So first we assign the temporary pointer, the head node. Then using this only we move. So till it reaches the end of the node, we print the value in the data field, and then we move to the next node by using this statement temp equal to temp next. Then destroy list. Here we are going to destroy the whole list. So head is no more needed. But anyway, the node which is pointed by the head has to be removed, deleted. So for that, what we do is till head, here we are moving the head itself. So first we, till head is not equal to null, what we do is first we are assigning the temp to head, and then we move the head itself to the point to the next node. Then we delete the node which is pointed by the pointer temp, and so on. So when it when the while loop is over, the total linked list will be destroyed. Then update. Here we pass the old value and new value. If we check whether it is the whether any node is there or empty. If head is equal to null, then we can say the list is empty, or else we have to move inside and get the value. So current equal to head, current not equal to null. We use a temporary pointer called current, and then initially the current is made to point to the head node, and then till it reaches the end of the null, then we move next node by this statement. Now when in the for loop, initially current is made to point to the head of the node, then we check whether the data field in the current node is equal to old value. If so, we have found the node, and then we overwrite the old value with the new value, and then return. We don't proceed, or else we keep on searching, we keep on going, and then till we find the node where our old data is matching. Then once it is matched, we overwrite that with the new value, and then finally, or else if it reached the end of the list and still it is not matching, the data is not matched with the old value, then you can print the statement as the old value is not present, the data is not present, so you cannot tell it. If it is there only, if it is there only, you can update, or else you cannot update. So this message will be printed. Now this is the main program where we have declared the local variables, integer, etc., and then the pointer variable, node, temporary variables. Then we have created an object called list1, which is of type linked list. And then in a menu-driven program, we get the values, and while doing so, we insert and then delete and searching, all those things we are doing. So in the case one, we are getting the value in the main program and we pass it to the function. And with deletion also the same way, we get the value and then it search and find the value and delete. Enter the value to be searched. Here we are getting that value and we pass it to that, and it return, if it is present, it returns yes or no. Then if that updation also, we get the old value and the new value to be updated. Then this these two values are passed to this member function, update list and traverse list and destroy list. and then this is used for checking whether the list is empty or not. Now we'll run this program. Now I'm going to insert. Now we are going to insert a node. Now I press when I select the first choice. Now I'm going to insert the node with the value 50. Okay, now I'll insert one more. 30, and then again 90. See, first I have entered a 50 and then 30 and 90, not in an order, but when you traverse, automatically the insertion will be done in order. So first smallest element and then and so on. So here now I am going to insert one more element, let us say 45. We'll see how it is inserted. See, it is correctly inserted in between this. Then for that it uses searching and then different. Now we will see search an element. Let me see whether I have 50 is in my list or not. Yes, it is present, so it gives the value. Yes, suppose I want to update a value, so I want to update old value as 50 and new value to be 55. Now I traverse, we'll see whether it has changed. Yes, it has been changed. Now I want to delete a value, so enter the value to be deleted, 45. Now again I'm searching, see here the 45 is remove, and then now I want to destroy the whole list. Yes, it is list. Now I check whether it is empty or not by pressing yes. Yes, the list is empty. Now I quit.